Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. This is lecture number 3 on mass transfer. The topic for the discussion are convective mass transfer, analogy between momentum, heat and mass transfer. And we had 2 lectures earlier on the mass transfer. In those 2 lectures, we discussed the fixed law of diffusion, diffusion in gases, EQML or counter diffusion, isothermal evaporation of water. The previous 2 lectures were on the diffusive mass transfer, and this lecture is on the convective mass transfer. And after completion of this lecture, the student will be able to discuss the convective mass transfer and the various correlations used in the convective mass transfer. And the student will be able to explain the analogy between momentum, heat and mass transfer. So the mass transfer coefficient, first definition. So the diffusive mass flux of component A, the mass transfer of component A in a mixer, MA is given by KA into CA1 minus CA2. Where K is the mass transfer coefficient, A is the area, and CA1, CA2, they are the concentrations through which diffusion occurs. And here the equation, in this equation, K is the mass transfer coefficient. So this equation is very much similar to the convective heat transfer equation, Q equal to HEA into T infinity minus TW. So in the convective equation, H is the heat transfer coefficient. Here K is the mass transfer coefficient. So here in the convective mass transfer discussion, the main objective is we have to determine the K, mass transfer coefficient. Using the correlations, we have to find out the mass transfer coefficient value K. And there are some non-dimensional numbers connected with the mass transfer calculations, convective mass transfer calculation. First number is Sherwood number, which is the ratio of concentration gradient at the boundary by diffusion to the concentration gradient at the boundary by convection. And the Sherwood number is given by substituting the values. It is reduced to KL by D for flow over flat plate and KD, small d by capital D, for flow over the cylindrical system, where the K is the mass transfer coefficient, L is the length of the plate, capital D is the diffusion coefficient, and small d is the diameter of the pipe or sphere. And skimmed rate number is defined as the ratio of molecular diffusivity of momentum to molecular diffusivity of mass, which is nu by d. So this is very much equal to the Prandtl number in the heat transfer calculation. The Sherwood number is equal to the Nusselt number in the heat transfer calculations. And another third number here in the mass transfer, Lewis number, which is the ratio of heat diffusivity to mass diffusivity, which is alpha by D, where alpha is the thermal diffusivity and D is the diffusion coefficient. So these 3 numbers are important for mass transfer calculations. And the convective mass transfer correlation for flow over flat plate, a local Sherwood number for laminar flow for flat plate. The flow is laminar. Again, you look at the equation, Sherwood number equal to 0.332, Reynolds number to the power 0.5, and skimmed rate number to the power 0.33. The Reynolds number you have to find out for the flow. When the Reynolds number is less than 5 into 10 power 5, the flow is laminar. When the Reynolds number is more than 5 into 10 power 5, the flow is turbulent. And the average Sherwood number for the laminar flow, Sherwood number equal to 0.664 into Reynolds number to the power 0.3 and skimmed rate number to the power 0.33. The average Sherwood number for the turbulent flow, it is 0.037 into Reynolds number to the power 0.8. Then the Kilton-Kalburn analogies for flow over smooth plate, the laminar flow, K by U infinity, skimmed rate number to the power 0.67 equal to 0.332, Reynolds number to the power minus 0.5. And skimmed rate turbulent flow, K by U infinity, U infinity the velocity of the flow, Scheimlich number to the power 0.67 equal to 0.0296, Reynolds number to the power minus 0.2. And the flow over cylinder, we have this correlation, square root number equal to Kd by D equal to C into Reynolds number to the power n, and Scheimlich number to the power 0.333. And the value of C and n, you can take it from the table. So this equation is very much similar to the Nusselt number equal to C into Reynolds number to the power n and Prandtl number to the power 0.333. For flow inside the pipe, for turbulent flow, when the Reynolds number is more than 2300, the flow is considered as turbulent flow. For turbulent flow, Sherwood number equal to 0.023, Reynolds number to the power 0.83, and Scheimlich number to the power 0.44. And for simultaneous heat and mass transfer, majority of the applications simultaneously is occurring. H by K equal to rho into Cp into Lewis number to the power 0.67, where the Lewis number is already we defined alpha by D, heat diffusion divided by the mass diffusion. Now we discuss the analogy between momentum, heat and mass transfer. So momentum transfer, it is fluid mechanics, only fluid flow. Heat transfer in the convection, it is heat transfer with the fluid flow. So mass transfer, it is fluid flow with the mass transfer. So the combination of fluid flow, the fluid is bulk movement of the fluid will be there. At the same time, there will be species transport. That is what the mass transfer. Now, what is the relationship between momentum, heat and mass transfer that we are going to discuss? This topic is important from the examination point of view. The continuity equation, dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y equal to 0. The momentum equation, u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y equal to nu into dou square u by dou y square. Energy equation, u into dou t by dou x plus v into dou t by dou y equal to alpha into dou square t by dou y square. And mass transfer equation, u into dou c a by dou x plus v into dou c a by dou y equal to d into dou square c a by dou y square. So for momentum transfer, we will take the first and the second equation. For heat transfer, we take the first, second and third equation. And for the mass transfer, we take the first, second and the fourth equation. So momentum transfer, there is only fluid flow. Heat transfer, there is fluid flow and heat transfer. Mass transfer, there is fluid flow and the species transport. And using the momentum equation, we have drawn this diagram. So this is the velocity bound layer. For fluid mechanics, this is velocity bound layer. And within the velocity bound layer, we have to consider the effect of the viscosity of the fluid. And nu, kinematic viscosity, plays important role. And outside the bound layer, we ignore the effect of viscosity of the fluid. And here, the velocity profile is given. The velocity profile indicates how the velocity is varying from the surface of the plate to the fluid side, up to the bound layer. So the velocity bound layer, velocity profile, it is governed by the kinematic viscosity, nu. And this is thermal bound layer. From the energy equation. So, energy equation is governing the thermal bound layer and thickness of the bound layer and the temperature profile, delta T and temperature profile. So, temperature profile, it is what the line, how the temperature is varying within the bound layer. It is governed by the energy equation, particularly the thermal diffusivity of the material. Alpha is the thermal diffusivity of the fluid. And this is the concentration profile, which is governed by the mass transfer equation. There is fluid flow and the species transport. So the concentration profile and the concentration bound layer is governed by this equation, and the value of the concentration profile and bound layer thickness is governed by the diffusion coefficient D. So in the first velocity bound layer, kinematic viscosity is important, and thermal bound layer, thermal diffusivity is important, and for concentration profile or concentration bound layer, diffusion coefficient is important. Interestingly, the nu, alpha and d, they take the same unit, meter square per second. Now, when the velocity and the temperature profile will be the same for nu equal to alpha, that is Prandtl number equal to 1. When the Prandtl number equal to 1, nu equal to alpha, so velocity and the temperature profile will be the same. And when the Scheimlich number equal to 1, nu equal to d, and the velocity and the concentration profile will be the same. And when Lewis number equal to 1, alpha equal to d, then the temperature and the concentration profile will be the same. That is what relationship. Velocity and the temperature profile will be the same for Prandtl number equal to 1. Velocity and the concentration profile will be the same for skim unit number equal to 1. And temperature concentration profile will be the same for Lewis number equal to 1. When all the three numbers are equal to 1, then velocity, temperature and the concentration profile will be the same. When Prandtl number equal to, skim unit number equal to, Lewis number equal to 1. That is what the relationship between, comparison between momentum transfer, heat transfer and the mass transfer. So, these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And this is the book what I have published. You can use it for further information. And you can write to me for any queries on the subject. I will sincerely answer. And you can comment on the video for improvement. Until then, thank you for watching.